All right, we're gonna take 3 minutes and then we're gonna keep pushing north.
Should I contact the other team?
Yeah, contact Mitra and tell her that we have cleared the north side wilderness.
Mitra, clear the north side wilderness.
I can smell Cathar City from here.
Do you think that the council wants us to pull out?
You already know my thoughts on Jedi politics.
Malak.
What do you have?
They killed them all. Even the children.
Revan.
Not even the Sith would. This is depraved.
Then we make them pay. We burn the foundation of the Mandalore from the ground up. We bring them justice.
Malak, Revan, you and I both know that Master Lamar
is wrong and weaker for it.
Jedi pacifism led us here. We let this happen.
Yes, Master.
And you, Malak?
I trust Revan. He hasn't been wrong before, and I doubt he will now.
I see.
Is that a yes, then? Master, can we finally take the fight to Mandalore?
Revan, I understand your desire, but we must not get involved. The Council's decision stands. The Council is in session soon. May the Force be with you.
May the Force be with you. The dark side surrounds these times, and the council does nothing. They're scared to make things worse, but their inaction is not dissimilar.
It's not just the council, Malak. The entire order sits by and does nothing.
We are not alone.
We let them do nothing.
We're not alone. There are others who would join us, others who have.
But how long does it last? Well, we don't have the resources to go on indefinitely. It's only a matter of time until inaction spreads.
Not necessarily. I have some ideas if you'd like. That's fine. We'll discuss this later. I'll go prepare the ship. Message me when you're done meditating. This shouldn't take too long.
Thank you. There is no emotion, there is peace. There is no passion, there is serenity. There is no ignorance, there is knowledge. There is no chaos, there is harmony. There is no death, there is no force. There is no emotion, there is peace. There is no emotion, there is peace. There is no emotion, there is peace.
Yeah, I'm fine.
No, I'm not.
Mitra, am I a good man?
Of course.
No, I mean, am I?
Well, why wouldn't you be?
I don't know. It's nothing.
It doesn't sound like nothing.
Wow, great.
Well, we're only as good as what we choose to do, even when forced to do otherwise. Are you sure you don't want to talk about it?
I'm fine.
The Council does not take this proposition lightly, Malak.
I understand, Masters.
These are dark times, and we must proceed with caution, lest dark times fall on the Order as well.
I know, Masters, but what Revan saw
may only be a symptom of the growing darkness.
Growing darkness, Master Dorak? Masters?
Not too far outside the temple? There grows a presence in the hills, deep within the ancient burial mounds, sealed by the Jedi Masters of old. The entrance has grown cold, no longer responding to either the force of our lightsabers. A great darkness surrounds the mounds, unlike that which we've seen before here on Dantooine, a shadow drenched in the blood of the Empire.
Does the Council have any idea what their purpose is?
Not as of yet. But we do have theories.
Zeskai.
What we do know is that the more we meditate on the structure, the more impregnable the presence grows. Almost as if imposing the light on the structure causes it to grow in darkness.
Have you considered that it might respond more favorably to the dark side?
That is our present theory.
But if we are correct, then it may be best left undisturbed. Because if the dark side is key, then think of the horrors that the tomb may unleash.
Malak, where is Revan?
Resting, Master.
We will summon him once he is ready. These are very important matters.
Masters!
Revan?
We have a situation.
I sense a change in you, Revan.
Yes, Master. In the plains, I found a gateway within the burial mounds.
This we were just discussing. And the door...
Open to my touch, Masters.
The two of you have given us much to think about. The Council will deliberate, and we will summon you when we have made our decision.
Yes, Masters.
Until that time, you are not to approach the dark structure again. Does the Council make itself clear? Revan? Malak?
Yes, Masters.
You two are dismissed.
Thank you, Masters.
Are we going to...
Of course not, Malak.
Just making sure. How did you find this place?
I felt a presence call out.
A good one? Or not?
This is
Yeah.
Well, how did we open it?
I'm not sure.
How did you open it before?
I think I...
Evan?
Did I just...
I believe so.
Onwards.
I sense... I don't know what I sense.
I know what you mean.
Heard it.
I'm gonna blow it.
No, wait! We understand you. We're the builders. Why did the builders build this monument? And can we have your knowledge?
The what?
We have deliberated upon the information you provided us. Firstly, you will stay away from the burial mounds as far as possible. It is the Council's opinion that a nexus of the Dark Force such as this is too much for any Jedi to resist, even our best, let alone our warriors.
Yes, Master.
Which brings us to our next point. Although we are not in total agreement, it is the Council's decision to permit you and whoever may wish to follow you to be deputized into the Republic Army as a Mercy Corps.
Thank you, Masters.
It's your paperwork, Revan.
Of course, Master.
You are both dismissed, though I may suggest that you travel to Coruscant in order to arrange the specifics of your engagement with the military and with Supreme Chancellor Kressa.
Thank you, Master.
Something troubles you, Master Dorak.
I sense a growing darkness beyond the tombs.
Dark times lie ahead.
Indeed.
You're awfully quiet.
I'm just thinking. Malak, I don't know what to make of the map we found.
How do you mean?
Remember the whispers that drew me in?
Yes, I recall.
I don't know, something about them seems... No. Eternal.
You didn't tell the council, though.
Me and the council, Malik?
You're not wrong.
Still, dark times lie ahead.
Balban.
Babir bitis kor ti anakandade hardantulin?
Nais kaises. Vikelidneris mit desitiminaris secretui bakvi linabar. Dumir. Desetisi et zak satorat pizanobik. Kujir meg valvabir zati. Balkujir te verde penaik.
Lek. Mandayai.
Si, vi che li risate che li date. Paltenosi, ad cugir.
You know, it is exciting.
Speak for yourself, I live to see this war's end.
I wonder when the next time we'll see the Enclave is.
Who knows, maybe we'll be changed men.
Indeed.
I'm gonna miss the Dantooine cafeteria though.
Oh, the churros.
The churros.
Wookiees have it bad enough as is, given the Circa presence. So we want to at least try to reduce the Mandalorian influence, if at all possible.
Are we not going to do anything about Circa?
What can we do?
Well, if we do nothing, then we're barely better than Mandalore.
Telvin, are you comparing the utter atrocities committed by the Mandalorians to the Republic wartime pragmatism?
That's the way to put it.
Telvin, I ask you here because I trust you.
Enough! If we are going to get anything done here, then the both of you need to shut the hell up.
Sorry, Rat.
Yeah, me too.
Alright, well, the problem that I'm finding is that just north of here, there is a ray-shielded gateway.
Mandalorian?
By the looks of it, you know, I don't see the Wookiees building anything down here, so...
Alright, so what's the plan?
Alright, well, as I was saying, that is our next objective. Normally I would say we need a plan of attack, but the Shadowlands are so uncharted and unpredictable that it will be best if we just enter with the intent to improvise.
This will be interesting.
Indeed it will. Alright, it's almost morning, so gear up, rest a little bit, and may the Force be with you.
Master Dorak is so pretentious.
You're not wrong.
Alright, let's go again.
Okay. Alright. Let's go. Ah! You call that dueling?
You little...
Ah!
You know, Talvin, we may not agree on much, but I am glad you're here.
Thank you, Revan. It's all right. I think I agree with you more than Malik, I hope.
I mean, he's not wrong. We can only do so much at one time.
But at what point do we sacrifice not just our code, but our honor as well?
Honor is a fool's errand, Talvin. You yourself chose to be here against the wishes of the Jedi Council.
I go against the Council because they're afraid to do what's right. But there is a way to have the best intentions and still fail.
Hold.
Yes, Malik?
It's been a few hours. Let's hold for 5 and then we'll get back at it.
As you said.
Sniper, Petra.
On it.
Wait, look, he's not Mandalorian.
Yes, he is!
Malik!
Malik!
For you.
This will be interesting.
Revan, you just stopped Malik from going too far. Don't join him.
I stopped Malik from going too far, but this is necessary.
Revan, what the hell do you think this is?
Talvin.
Talvin, if we aren't willing to do what it takes to win, we risk losing everything we try to protect.
Now, I'm not going to enjoy this. But the best thing to do is to make sure you don't either.
Alec, gain control of your emotion. Your anger and frustration unbalance you.
Revan's just as emotional.
Yeah, but mine is focused, Malik.
Alec raises a good point, Revan. Your focus is not in peace, but in channeling your anger. A Jedi thinks not of these things. Do you understand me?
Yeah, sorry, Master.
Don't be, either of you. Master Jar would be very proud of where both of you are.
Thank you, Master.
Well done out there.
Come on, Revan.
Oh, I mean it, Malik.
I don't understand. How do you do it every time?
The truth?
Yes?
I use my anger. Just a little bit.
You couldn't tell. Still though, Revan, that's the dark side.
I'm still a Jedi.
I suppose.
Did I hear that correctly?
Case.
Now, far be it for me to tell you how to use the Force, but to be fair, that's unfair. No one else uses the dark side of the Force so discreetly. Perhaps I should ask Master Lamar if I could even out the playing field. Just a little bit? I'm sure he would love to give his opinion about this.
That's good. This is better.
A lot of effort for barely anything.
Better than nothing.
Are you too serious?
Talvin, don't.
You too, Mitra? Revan and Malik go on their little crusade and you just stand there and bite your lip?
I don't disagree with you.
Talvin, are you really telling me you don't feel that hunger inside of you? That insatiable desire for justice?
Hunger is a very dangerous form of chaos.
You are right, Talvin. Honestly, you are. But right now, we are here. We are in the Shadowlands, and that is where we are going to stay, in darkness, until we get the hell out. And that is only going to happen once we actually do something. Do you understand me?
We're Jedi. We'll be fine.
I have heard that before.
And it is always wrong.
What has happened here?
We had a duel. Revan won. All good fun.
All right, but take caution. There is such a fall, even joined with righteous purpose.
Revan, I know when something's bothering you.
You can read me better than Malik. Maybe you should share your notes.
Malik is Malik, Revan.
A very low bar, I know. I don't know. It's just this whole situation.
I thought you didn't care.
That's the point.
Why don't you go tell Talvin that? It might bring him some comfort.
No, I know that sounds like it will work, but it should trust me. People like Talvin, they need a strong leader. You know, I know Talvin's not too far gone, but his idealism can really get in the way sometimes. Sometimes you need to save people from themselves.
Forget how old I was when I was accepted into the Order. I don't even remember my parents. How old were you?
What? I don't know. Young. It doesn't matter.
I think it does.
Why?
You know why. Council watches over us like children. It's infuriating, I know. But it honestly makes sense. We have the worldly experience of children.
Like we outgrow that when we leave the temple and we become Padawans.
Revan, we're young, but your eyes are so old. The authoritative nature of the Council is because they have the fear of what others can gain. I may be wrong, but yours comes from the fear of what others can lose.
What's wrong with that?
Nothing. That's the point.
Mitra, on Dantooine, Malik and I,
we finished.
Better get going.
Talvin, can I speak to you? I owe you an apology.
You do.
Not for that. I mean, for not explaining why we do what we do, Talvin.
Try me.
Talvin, we have a choice. We cannot avoid sacrifices, so we choose what we lose. We either lose ourselves, so ever so slightly, or we lose this war. And that is our choice.
There has to be another way.
Well, if you find one, let me know.
Hey, you all ready?
Yeah, one sec. Am I making myself clear? I know I'm not always the best at communication.
No, I understand. I mean, I wholeheartedly disagree with you, but I understand.
You seem quiet.
I'm in thought, Malik. I don't know if what we did was right.
What do you mean? It was your idea.
I mean, we sought strength, that's fine. You know, anger is a focusing lens, but... But we used Case's fear to give him weakness, to take his strength. Another Jedi.
Like you said, it was his weakness, it's his mistake. Let's go again.
All right.
Master Dorak, can I meet with you very soon?
Wait.
What is it, Mitra?
I don't know.
What is it, Mitra?
Malak.
It's something bad. On Dantooine.
We have to get back to the Enclave. It's the only nexus big enough that we could feel it out here.
Agreed. Malak signaled the ship's beacon. We'll have to go back now.
On it.
Anyway, Talvin, let's...
Yes, Revan?
Go without me. That's something to deal with.
Are you not coming with us? Let's get going.
Wait, no, Revan!
It's fine, Revan, it's fine. We've gotta get going.
No, but I sense
Come
something!
Come on, Mitra!
Alright. Now, who are you?
There's been an attack. Mandalorians!
How could you betray the Order, Cass?
Me? Master Doric. You haven't even alerted the High Council of Revan and his following.
Revan leads a Mercy Corps.
So they say.
Master!
Who are you?
Not answer my question.
I sense the dark side in you.
And I in you.
What do you want?
I wish to learn.
What?
I was once a great king. But now I am a traveler. A learner.
And about what do you want to learn?
About you, Revan.
What the hell does that mean?
Last I checked, you were here with me.
You were lost in this woods, haunted by the whispers of silence and perpetuity. Let you be found.
Jedi are so arrogant.
She's not the only one.
So a challenge, then.
Surrender now, or you will be destroyed.
I've been armed by the scores of your butchered Jedi.
You claim that we're arrogant? Okay, let's see if it's justified.
Why are you here? What does Mandalore want? Now!
Carmorir ruzit ijat jediste! Manyaim et ultime nihoi iror! Tel dal brigar republic! Azadgar jeltiste! Kerjite mirir urskir! Vigelir shukti karatate! Tarvar el jala!
Shut him up, Alec! I don't care!
Shagun jetale!
Disillusionment grows. It will not stop with your order.
Avenir. Tetra Guir Avenir Te Dior.
What did he mean?
Nothing. Wails of a wounded beast.
You're too short-sighted, Malik.
You're too focused
Can
on
we
details.
Focus?
Sorry, Mitra.
Where's Bastila Shan?
Yeah.
You alright?
Right as rain.
What do the Mandalorians want?
Something with the younglings. I'm not sure specifically. Where's Revan?
Revan was busy.
You weren't listening to me, Malik. I was trying to tell you there was something in the forest.
Shadowlands are full of darkness.
No. Something else. Something worse.
What do you think you'll find, my child?
Why are you following me?
One should not be alone in this desolate place.
You are. I'm not looking for anything in particular.
Yet, you follow a clear path. You wear the weapon of a god, shadowed by the face of a warrior. Yet, why do you remain a Jedi?
The Republic needs us.
They need you, rather not the Jedi.
I don't have to be the best Jedi to do the best I can.
Empires venerate warriors in times of war, and crucify them in times of peace.
I don't believe that.
Then perhaps you are a greater fool than I had thought.
It doesn't matter. I will do what I have to do to save lives.
You claim to save what you take.
I may mourn for the dead, but I will do what I must.
You are not ready yet. Soon, my child.
You keep spitting out words and words and sounds and sentences, but what does it even mean? What does any of it damn mean?
Yes. Very soon.
Who are you?
Elek. Daljander case nice. Rulis de junior arserim burin chatalil bete jetise trasim batantum.
Vi kibir isaiti canar.
Nice or yachil.
Balban.
Vi nice canar var evala. A ogir kuyir a shi jetise tinyod ad kelir to kun lar.
Ibi kujir zeraris.
Ibi kuyir akan madayayim. Viva bir bik ibak vi enteor.
Malman.
Attract your communicator, Revan. What is it you wanted to show me?
Look, Malik.
By the stars.
It's another piece. Another piece to the puzzle.
How did you find it?
I followed the whispers again.
Do you know what they are?
No. I don't.
of a long-range communicator?
Get out of here.
I'll take that as a yes.
You got guts, kids. All right, I'll give you 2 minutes.
This is Jacques Rand with the Republic Strategic Information Service. I have a message for Jedi Rebel.
Intelligence reports indicate that there are several Mandalorian warships en route to the Serico system, armed with countless nuclear warheads. The Republic military is in disarray as usual, and the Jedi Council does nothing. According to the SIS, you aren't too far away to help. You know what I want. Rand out.
When did we get this?
2 days ago.
2 days.
What do you think, Revan?
Mitra?
He's right.
We have to do something.
Master Kang will say that she must put herself too thin and will fail at already impossible tasks.
Does she know how to say anything positive?
Should the time arise.
But truly, Talvin, I have fought this battle and I have lost.
We are fighting on now.
Talvin's right, we have to do something.
So is Master Kang, but she would be. But how we feel about this doesn't matter. Not just abandon our mandate.
I'll go to Serico.
If you believe that's wise.
I'll be fine. I'll run back to the ship and grab my gear.
Which of you have been to Narshadon?
Talvin? Well, you know, Narshadon is the capital of temptation and lust. And I'm a Jedi.
Well, in the Corellian sector to the west, there is a cantina, or I suppose a speakeasy known as the Urbanus. This has, of course, indicated that the management has an association with Mandalorian leadership. As in, Mandalore the Ultimate could be there? Not likely. He hasn't been seen publicly in months, and as I suppose indicated that right now, the ship is trapped through the Alchemy. Would you leave a right hand in place? Mandalore doesn't have one. Of course he does. No, I agree with Malak. And if you're wrong, and Mandalore is contacted, let's hope our lightsabers are faster than the communicators.
Get a Spotchka.
Coming up.
You look familiar, kid.
Must be one of those faces.
No, that's not it.
I promise it is.
No, I... Sorry, kid. I must just be cloudy.
Spotchka. That'll be 12 credits.
Cassus! Enjoy your drink. Talvin, you take the bar. Malak, you're with me. Let's go.
Customs, please transmit your docking clearance. Docking clearance accepted. Welcome to Serico, Master Jedi.
I'm free to upgrade.
Welcome to Serico, Master Jedi. We've seen the reports and we know why you're here. We appreciate your arrival. Word has been sent to the Republic, but we've received no reply.
I would not put my faith in the strength of the Republic military.
Ma'am, I'm with the Republic military.
Can you understand me?
Unfortunately, you're not too far off.
So many of them are coming.
Not more than we can normally handle with our regional defenses.
So what's the problem?
Several ships wouldn't be a problem, but they're being led by a dreadnought.
What's the difference?
Mandalorians are brutal, but unintelligent. Dreadnought captains are different.
So which captain is it?
I don't know. It could be anyone. Even Mandalore himself.
What do you think it is?
No. We're not that unlucky.
What do you think, Malak?
No. This place is seedy, but doesn't scream Mandalorian.
That's what I was thinking.
I do sense something, though.
Me too. It's familiar.
You work here?
I'm new, but yeah, what can I get you?
What can you tell me of the Mandalorian presence here?
The what?
The...
What the hell are you talking about?
Never mind.
We have a problem.
Which is?
Cassis!
Damn it!
You all had to make this a hell of a lot more complicated.
Who are you?
Agent Acilla Rice, SIS.
Oh.
Yeah.
Rev, let's talk.
We simply don't have enough time to...
General, they're almost here.
Thank you, soldier.
Well, we have to do something.
Well, there's not much we can do. Yes, this is the General. Come in.
General, I'm afraid to report an arm shuttle just slipped past our sensors.
Did it look Mandalorian?
By the looks of it, though it's hard to tell.
Where are they hiding?
That's the thing, General. They're not.
Please, explain.
As soon as the shuttle landed, they began emitting a locator beacon on a Serico frequency.
Thank you. I'll take a look at this.
Give me the coordinates, I'll handle it.
It could be a trap.
Well, better be.
General. I see signs of crashed ship close by, but ship's transponder sent me here. Hello?
She can't hear you.
Dorjander Case.
Meet you, sir. I know that.
You gave the Mandalorians our young.
I am here to help.
Mitra!
Rikes. Explain yourself. You don't have long.
You were right. You, Revan, Malak, all of you.
You regret what you did?
No. I saw balance, and I thought the Mandalorians understood that. But I realized I was wrong. The Mandalorians breed chaos. Chaos breeds imbalance. An imbalance not easily corrected.
So what? What does any of this mean? Serico is doomed to ash.
Serico may fall. But that's the price of war.
You're a disgrace to your lightsaber. You really thought you could undo everything you've already done?
No. At least not alone.
Not alone?
It's not just us. We stand with 100 others ready to defend the Republic.
Why do you come here? It's Revan who leads us.
We join because we're needed. And we're needed here.
I delayed the Mandalorians as long as I could. It may have just been long enough. We should head back to the Republic Forward Command.
Where are my manners? Take a seat.
What do you want?
To learn about you. I've heard so much, Revan. You know, I was there that day, at the Battle of Anquo. We took a lot of Republic lives that day.
Children's are next.
Well, aren't you special? You know, I always thought of the Jedi as a self righteous, insolent group of people. Less concerned about peace and more about order.
You're not wrong.
So then we have an understanding.
I wouldn't go that far.
No, but I would. I've been watching you, Revan. You don't fight like a Jedi. You don't command like a Jedi. You're something new.
I am what I have to be.
That doesn't mean you can't like it. You have a look in your eye, Revan. A look I've seen many a time.
Let me guess, in the mirror.
Well, yes. But that is not what I was going to say. You have the look of a warrior, Revan. A warrior whose goals and ideals are perverted by the insolence and cowardice of the people you try so hard to protect.
I do what I do for the Republic.
And they squander your sacrifice! Your scars pave the path to their salvation. And yet they tread on that path with avarice and cowardice of children.
Right.
I got a little upset.
I didn't hear any blaster fire.
I'm fast.
Firepower to take even one of their cruisers.
We may not need to.
What do you mean?
It's possible, though extremely unlikely, that...
Dorjander.
Possible that Admiral Kerr's fleet may arrive just in time.
If we send enough small and fast fighters to bombard their warships, we might stand a chance.
It won't do any damage. It's like throwing pebbles at a bantha.
But the Mandalorians will overcommit their defenses forward. And when Kerr's fleet comes out from behind in hyperspace, that might be enough.
And if they don't get there on time?
Then we're all dead anyway.
May the Force be with us.
Something like that. Come on, Case. Let's go join the Strike Force.
You've never been to the Dantooine Captain's Arc?
I've heard so many things. Bad things.
No. Okay, they used to be bad.
Well, yeah, I'm gonna pass on that.
All right, I am gonna go get another.
Be honest, Revan. Do you ever think we'll go too far?
Well, we can't think like that. The more we worry about our souls, just time wasted.
How do you mean?
Just the more we juggle more these hypothetical moral constructs, we lose our grasp upon the material galaxy.
I don't know what that is, but that's not an answer.
Listen, I understand about 2% of your Jedi talk, but what I do know is that what you all do means a lot to a lot of people. Lately, a lot of people have grown to hate the Jedi, but it seems only the Jedi hate you, if that makes any sense.
We are back in business.
I'm good.
Yeah, me too.
I'm not.
Hey!
Revan, may I speak to you?
Okay.
What can I do for you?
So, Cassus Fett. Shame he's dead.
I wouldn't say so.
He would have made a valuable prisoner.
And a dangerous enemy.
So the best of your order couldn't take him alive with all your Jedi tricks?
Agent Alyssa, I want to show you something.
Now, I'm not complaining, but I know what you did, Jedi.
Where's that agent waitress lady of your drink?
Probably on her break.
Alright.
Hello, Mr. Mitra.
Mitra, what's happening?
Revan, I'm here with Dorjander Case, and...
Dorjander Case is there?
Yes, Revan.
Mitra, but... I want you to take that man and...
Revan!
Mitra, I order you to take that traitor and...
gone! At least all life on it.
Your mission...
Malak.
No, Revan, Malak is right. I failed. Anytime I try to reach out and feel the planet, I sense a Terran force.
Mitra, how did you escape?
Admiral Sol Kerth's fleet arrived to fight the Mandalorians, but it was too late.
What do we do?
I believe I can help with that.
Have you not already served your purpose, traitor?
We are ready to fight. All of us.
All of you?
I filed a request for a 328 Eric from Republic High Command.
I sense we're gonna need it.
Do not heed the words of the Jedi Council. The Republic will fall if we do not act now. Already the Mandalorians have butchered countless systems along the Outer Rim. They will only grow more powerful with time. We must use our might to help the Republic in its time of need. The Jedi Council is wise, but will take too long to deal with this threat. We must act now to stop the Mandalorians, and as the twin suns rise on Tatooine, every last Mandalorian, man, woman, or child, will burn.
We are severely outgunned. The Republic was never ready for a war, let alone one against the Mandalorian.
We make do with what we've got.
Exactly. The Mandalorians know they are unbeatable, which makes them beatable. Mandalore will focus too much effort towards the efforts on Malachor and the Republic. to allow us to slip in from behind.
That's why we're on Duxon. This is the last place they would expect us to come from.
Precisely.
We'll end where it began.
Once we're on board, we're going to need to split into two teams, one stealth and one assault. Talvin, you're going to be in stealth, and you're going to be with Master K, and you will disable the lateral weaponry so that we may actually escape instead of getting shot down when we're done. Mitra, you're with me, and we'll take the fight directly to Mandalore himself.
What about Malak?
He'll be with us as well.
What's Dorjander Case doing?
I'll be behind lines relaying orders. Last time I remember, you all are generals, and without a way to relay orders to your troops, what's the purpose?
So what, is cutting off the head supposed to stop the Mandalorians from running around like a chicken?
If it doesn't work, we have another plan in place.
Which is?
We have an Iridonian engineer.
We don't have time for this. Case, when do we leave?
2 hours.
All right. All of you gear up. May the Force be with you.
I never thought it'd end up like this.
What do you mean?
Everything feels like it's coming together. Strange.
Well, you forged your own destiny through the fire, so...
Still. I never thought we'd have to go against the Council for this long.
What did you expect?
I don't know. I guess I just thought that us being out here protecting people, maybe it'd set an example for other Jedi.
It has. Look at Dorjander Case, look at Terran Rikes. It's the Council that needs correcting.
Correcting?
Talvin, look at everything that has been accomplished at our behest. At the behest of our willingness to act, our willingness to leave the skies of Coruscant and wade through the swamps of war.
I disagree with them, but they have their reasons.
It's cowardice.
It's caution.
It's weakness.
You don't trust the Council because you're not even a Jedi. You never were. You never even wanted to be.
Does that make me wrong?
I don't know. Just ask yourself what's more important. Strength or keeping the Republic together?
How about keeping the Republic together or keeping its people alive?
How are you feeling, Mitra?
Good.
Good.
Revan? I sense...
Okay.
I sense a dawning darkness.
I think you're right.
What do you mean by that?
Let's just call it a feeling.
Are we going to do something about it?
Eventually, yes, but I sense now is not the time.
We may not have the time.
We will. Make sure when this war is over, we'll figure this out together. I promise you.
I'm not here to tell you that nobody is going to die. We have lost so many of our Jedi brothers and sisters already. But what I will tell you is that we will rain hellfire on these Mandalorian terrorists, whatever the cost. And if we have to snuff out every last Mandalorian man, woman, and child, then that is what we will do. And I swear this mask shall never leave my face until I have Mandalore's heart resting in my hand. I am Revan. This is where we stand.
Revan, we have a problem.
What is it, Talvin?
Cassus Fett is alive. Again.
He just doesn't stay down, does he?
Orders?
Stick to the plan, Talvin.
All right, let's see. Master K could never.
Sukur Garmandayan, Odwalet Kirier Hetek Karatarin Garbierwal, Garbanier Ora Correxia Moratari.
Maybe Kuji's eyes.
Garkiri Nigia.
The Jedi's finest.
Long have I waited for this day. We finally come to a head, Revan.
Surrender, Mandalore.
I'd rather burn on a warrior's cross.
Go, both of you.
Revan.
This is my fight.
See you in hell.
Don't go without me.
It's just us now. Good. Very good.
May both be warriors, Mandalore. But your people will not remember you. And you will be the last Mandalore. I want to see the light leave your eyes.
Jedi. What? I was betrayed by your Sith. The red-skinned Sith. He led me to this tomb.
The tomb?
I was led against your Republic. I was betrayed. Avenge yourself, and avenge me.
We did it.
It's not over yet.
They have no leader. They'll surrender soon.
They are rabid animals with no alpha talent. They're so
We will return to our capital ship. Inform Beodur that phase 2 will begin, Mitra. What?
Case, confirm with Beodur that phase 2 will begin. We are on our way back.
What the hell is phase 2?
The gravity well. It will consume all the surrounding Mandalorian ships.
And the Republic ones.
Do you realize which ones, Talvin?
You're sending your dissidents to their deaths?
A small percentage of Republic lives are every last Mandalorian insect.
Every last Mandalorian? Revan, you're talking about genocide.
I'm talking about extermination!
They've already lost. Mitra. I won't let you do this.
Malak!
Yes?
Get him off the ship. Did I say to kill him? I'll get him the hell off my ship! Send him to Malak.
Malak, are you out?
Yes, I'm on the other shuttle we took in. We're currently approaching the docking port.
And Talvin?
By now, he'll be on Malachor's surface.
Alright.
case, patch me through to Bayodur.
Major, I once asked you if I was a good man.
That was a long time ago.
I know. You then said that we are only as good as what we're able to achieve.
That's not what I meant.
She passed out when the mass channel generator went off.
She may as well be dead.
Malak! What do you want from me, Revan? At least help me!
Cold in here, or is it just me?
Everything will be all right, Mitra. I promise. Have you seen Master Kay? She's probably gone.
It's for the best.
She was with me on the shuttle.
We've had no ships leave orbit. Are you sure she was with you?
I don't remember.
Figures, Master K was always very
elusive.
Yeah.
Malak, I don't know what to make of Mitra.
Life without the Force is life without life, Revan. As far as I'm concerned, she's... Still, she's still our ally.
How long can you stand in the abyss before it consumes you? Malak, Mandalor told me something before he died.
Yeah, I bet there were some words between the screams.
Malak, no. He told me that there is something else out there.
Beyond the Mandalorians?
What do you know of the Pure Blood Sith?
Mandalore is dead! All of you stand here no longer Jedi, but warriors. And we will follow
the Mandalorians into the unknown regions, and we will snuff out every last Mandalorian, man, woman, and child.
Revan, there is such a thing as too far. Do not prove the Council right.
Mitra's right. The Jedi Council doubted us. They doubt our strength and our resolve. We cannot stop until Master Lamar's blood waters the streets of Coruscant.
Malak!
Revan, what do you want? We've come this far.
We did this for the Republic.
The Republic that abandoned us, an order that stole us from our families and raised us with the might of warriors and the condescension of dogma?
We will burn the order in the night. To declare war on the Jedi is to declare war on the Republic.
What's one more war?
Malak.
You're right. I'm wet.
Revan.
I have heard cries of darkness coming from the unknown regions. Malak and I will lead all of you to find every last Mandalorian and snuff them out in these cries of darkness.
Who stands with Revan?
Who stands before me?
Kneel before Malak and Revan.
Revan, no, I know I can't stop you, but you cannot lead me into darkness.
After what you've done today? Mitra, how many of our brothers and sisters, Jedi, have that followed us on the righteous path lie dead because of what you have done today? Do not lecture me on the nuances of darkness.
If not me, then Talvin.
Case.
No!
Revan.
Get out.
Revan, I know.
This is not a mercy. I have felt what's inside of you. But what's not? As far as I'm concerned, you are already dead.
We should kill her. No.
Let the Council see what their hypocrisy brings. Let us mirror back in their eyes what they are. Let us see what the Jedi Council will do with their exile. Long live the Republic! Long live us!
course
it's
on!
Alright, I'll give you a motherfucking communicator. I'll give you a goddamn long-range communicator. You got 2 fucking minutes.
So wait. Part of it will be out there, part of it is gonna try to shoot it from up here. We may move around from shot to shot.
I've been banned from saying the word boom. So
you've been banned from not putting things in a safe position and just saying boom to disregard it.
Anyway, let's get going.
Let's get this cafeteria food, am I right, boys?
Hey!
Space Aramark!
Space Aramark!
Hi guys, welcome to my crib. Here we got Frederick. He's a light. And then let's see, cameraman. His name is also Frederick. Mine is actually also Frederick. That's how we were cast in this production.
You had to be named Frederick.
Yeah. Oh, you haven't met. Start again. They barely met. This is Frederick. Frederick. And Frederick just arrived.
Hold on. Bring the camera. We gotta say hi to Frederick.
Okay, only for Frederick.
Come.
Roll.
It's rolling.
Roll.
Frederick! This is Frederick!
I'm not even gonna ask questions.
Exactly.
Hi, Michael.
Hello.
Hi, don't welcome. This is my crib.
Do not call me.
This is Frederick.
Hello.
Frederick. This is Frederick.
Frederick 2.
This is Frederick.
Frederick 3.
Let's see the cameraman.
Shadow away.
That's Frederick as well. All right.
Do you remember the chorus?
Give me. And my name is also Frederick.
I wasn't.
Anyway.
Yes. Was she
is this Frederick?
Oh, behind the scenes.
Hello, Frederick.
Can you give a picture?
Hello, you're working with Frederick. Frederick? Frederick? I like the llama.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
I was doing so well.
Sebastian, introduce everyone.
It is pretty nice.
Oh, okay. This is Frederick.
Are we doing behind the scenes?
Yeah. This is Frederick.
Hello, I am from Germany. I put the tape on the wall.
Look at that.
Why does this feel like, who's next? Just do someone next.
That's also Frederick.
No, this is Jumbo Jumbo.
No, that's
Frederick.
Just check his script.
Frederick.
Frederick
2. Frederick.
Frederick.
New Frederick. We've known
Frederick.
This Frederick for a while.
College vlog. Frederick
again.
Frederick, show yourself. Hey, you didn't get me.
Have you guys seen that? This is gonna. If any of you run
Frederick.
For office, you're gonna get John Ossoff. Did anyone see the John Ossoff ads they would run? Where it was him in like a Star Wars movie with his friends, and they were like, too young to be a congressman.
We didn't have an audience around.
Yo, wait. Frederick, look. Frederick!
Oh shit!
Me.
Frederick!
Frederick! Frederick! Look, Frederick, look, I'm wearing a different costume.
That's just gonna go
Wait, on. Frederick, nice shirt. Frederick, show your shirt.
Frederick?
Oh, record me for a minute?
Yeah.
Hi, so follow me. Frederick, say hi.
Frederick Nicholson?
Frederick, say hi.
Hi.
Frederick, say hi.
What's up?
Frederick, say hi.
Hello.
Frederick, say hi.
Hi, what's happening?
Cameraman? Hi, Frederick.
Hi.
And a dangerous enemy.
The best your order could do is take him alive. Shame the best your order could do was not be able to take him alive.
Symbol. Should I mouth it to you, Bella?
Yeah, thank you.
It's a shame. So the best your order could do was not being able to take him alive. So the best of your order. So, pass this bet. Fuck you.
What can I do for you?
Okay. Was that the plan? Because otherwise I could... Oh, wait. Oh. Okay.
This is bloopers.
I'll talk to my father to see if I can stay, if I can just visit, or if I... I'll figure this out later. I'm in the middle of it, all right?
There's so many.
I'll talk to you in a minute. We're very close to being done. And then I'll call you, okay?
Yeah, not yet.
No shot.
It did say 10.
I know, you said 10.
I need to be done in 8 minutes.
My name and my
Lucas.
Dad's gonna kill me.
We
on our hot gang shit.
Yeah.
We out here.
Hey, maybe this gives them all the more reason.
In the woods.
Got some cool ass lights. We kind of looking hot, kind of looking sexy. No cap.
Oh, shit.
All the more reason I should get my license so I can just drive myself home whenever I want.
How you doing, Bella? How you doing?
Wait, hold still, I can't read the lines.
Alright.
Sean, this is your last time in the jeans. How do you feel?
Oh, thank God.
You telling me you don't like wearing my skinny jeans that from when I dressed up as Billy Joe Armstrong?
No.
Joan, it's your last day. How do you feel?
That's a wrap on Michael.
It's a wrap.
That's
this is our business deal. There's right now behind us there's a battle going on.
Oh shit.
Not anymore, that was just you.
What? Oh no.
Farewell, Talvin Essen, you're a bitch.
Cut.
That's a wrap on Riley.
Yeah, I did it.
You did it. Thank you, Mitra.
You're welcome. Glad I was of assistance.
Welcome to the University of North Carolina School of the Arts. This is what I'm doing right now. In the movement studio, one of them, room 116. Go Pickles.
Sebastian, how do you feel about the premiere today?
I feel so excited for the premiere today. This is my mother.
Oh, we know each other.
This is
she also funded the movie partially, fully.
Fully.
The sponsors for the movie are right here.
Father funded.
Yeah, we have two sponsors of this movie.
Here we have the poster.
The official Revan and the Prodigal Son poster.
Prodigal Night.
Here we have one of the stars of the film. I hope that you can hear me right now. She's ordering some popcorn for the movie. Okay, here we have one of the stars of the film. I've been narrating you this whole time. So, who do you play in this film, and what was your role?
I play Mitra Sturrock. She is a Jedi. She's relatively a good Jedi.
Okay, and how was this process for you becoming this character?
Well, see, I took a lot of research into this character.
Showed up? Okay. This is Bella. Who do you play in the film?
The waitress.
The waitress? How was getting into that character and how was the process for that?
I did some method acting.
Okay.
Waitress at all the places.
Okay.
I smart really well.
Your first ever film feature?
It is, and I'm so excited.
Wow, this is exciting. Okay, here we have Brooke. She might be in the film. We don't know yet.
The
back of the head.
I was not able to.
She's here to support.
What? We are outdoor voices.
Outdoor voices? Okay. Formal. I need to get my spray. Okay, and
No,
who did you play in the film? Who did you play in the film?
Girl, I don't know. Craig.
You know, I know that you know.
That's not the official
Stop showing. Ethan, where's the do the accent. Who did you play in the film?
I did an accent in this
movie. You said your
What was the accent?
Ethan, you said you're the British accent as the actor.
Come on now.
Okay, so how was the process of filming for you?
You know, it was really difficult.
Really? What was difficult about it?
You know, it was like just a lot of work.
Really?
Memorizing all of my lines.
Yeah, was it hard to get into character on set with such a fun cast?
You know, I really just like fused with my character, so
okay.
It's not hard.
Okay, that makes sense, yeah. So, okay. Should we get some Sprite?